Hello and welcome back to Mass Effect Andromeda, where we're still on Nexus and are trying to figure out what's up. I think we need to head back to the security station that was in the administration zone in order to deal with one of the missions that we're having. Docking bay? No, I actually want to go to operations, I think. I'm pretty sure. Right, let's go here. Additional tasks. No. Helios. Nexus. Yeah, let's track that. I think it's here. Yep. Network access instability detected, timestamp scrambled, playback corrupted. Okay.
This file is useless. Let's check another. And another scrambled file.
Coincidence seems unlikely.
Let's check another. This file is also corrupted. Definitely not a coincidence. You'd need pretty high clearance to mess with the security camera files. Somebody working for Kandros, maybe.
That is the most probable scenario.
Think you can get enough out of the files to find a match using biometric scans, Sam?
The files were badly scrambled, but if I combine all the available identifiers, it might work. Based on the limited information available, we are looking for a human male, assigned either to the Nexus or Hyperion. You will need to conduct scans from close proximity.
Got it.
All right, let's scan some males. That went out wrong. Let's scan some dudes.
Inaccurate match.
Disembarkation procedures for Hyperion are on hold. Please await further instructions.
Inaccurate match.
Alright. Guess there were more security people in the habitation area, so I guess we're gonna continue there. Alright.
Engineering update. We are working.
Match.
They must be thinking, what's this woman doing? She's just running in here, switching on a scanner and scanning me. That must feel like kind of weird. What the hell are you doing there, man?
Scan results show a partial positive. Target is most likely suspect.
Hey there.
Dale Atkins, right? We need to talk.
Look, not to be rude, but I have work to do.
I don't think so.
We know what you've been up to. You're done here.
I don't know what you're talking about. I'm just doing my job, that's all.
Proof says you've been up to no good.
Figures. Screw this. Screw all you hypocrites on this station. You weren't here when they kicked out our loved ones. Mutiny? We just wanted answers. My sister is out there. I don't even know if she's alive or...
Look, I can sympathize with that, but you're disrupting operations here, and I cannot condone this.
I'm sorry for what happened, but setting explosives isn't the answer.
Neither was sending people into exile because they didn't agree with policy. I don't care what you think. The mutiny leaders were right to demand to know what was going on.
You could have hurt people, killed them.
Like those who got killed when the leadership had the Krogan stomp on my friends? I'm done talking. I confess, it was me. Do whatever you want.
Well, it's not up to me.
Not my call. The Nexus leaders will make that decision.
That lot make a decision? That'll be the day.
Good. Seems like we solved that issue. Kinda. Let's get to our ship now, right? Oh, Captain.
Ryder.
You're not on the bridge, Captain?
We powered it down. Can't afford to waste energy. Though Cryo Bay and Sam Note are exempt. And I told them to keep their hands off Alex quarters. You have access now.
Thanks.
Hey, sorry about your father. He was really good at what he did. Just not so good at working with people. He was right about going planetside, though.
Well, he was always very caught up in his work.
As long as they did their jobs, he didn't care what people thought of him.
I noticed that. If there's anything else I can help with, let me know.
So what are you doing now that the Hyperion is just docked here?
Now that the Hyperion is docked, what will you do?
Normally, I'd supervise thawing out the colonists, but that's been put on hold. I hear you're the one helping resolve the issue. Good luck with that.
Thanks.
If someone had told you that you'd be in the Andromeda cluster even 5 years ago...
Are you kidding me? I'd have laughed them out of the quadrant. Although, the way things are now isn't exactly what I was hoping for, either. We all knew there was a possibility on arrival of less than ideal circumstances. When you sign up, you hope for the best, and plan for the worst.
Exactly.
Why did you join the initiative? We're a long way from home.
How could I not? I love my job. Coming here, all this, it was just a logical extension of what I already do. Sailing through new stars, discovering new worlds. What self-respecting explorer could pass that up?
Thanks for the talk.
All right. I have requests to submit, administrators to harass, and people to wake up. I'd better get to it. Good luck out there.
I have to do Pathfinder business, so take care. So, let's get back to the transit. So, this time we're gonna go to the docking bay, right? No, we're gonna go to the frickin' docking bay now.
Ready to see what Tan gave us?
I hear it's something special. Pathfinder en route. How's the ship?
In final checks, looking great.
We won't be long. The way things are going, we'll be on our own out there.
In other words, we're making this up as we go.
We used to call that tactical improvisation. But at least we'll be doing it in style. They call her the Tempest.
Let's go take a closer look.
Let's pick it up a bit, people. We're 14 months late.
So you're the one who's making everything happen. Vetra. Vetra Nix. Initiative wrangler, provisioner, gunner, and everything in between. Are we ready? The sooner we get out of here, the better.
You're coming with us?
Yes. Otherwise, there's no way they're letting this ship off the station.
Well, then let's get out of here.
Yeah. Let's go see the rest of Helios.
Hold it, hold it! You're not going anywhere.
Damn it.
Is there a problem?
Is something wrong?
Director Addison wants to see a complete report of the Tempest's supplies, munitions, and crew.
Director Tan overruled Addison.
The ship's loaded out with equipment for outpost discovery, squarely under Director Addison's purview.
Seeing you around. Ben, right? Came here with a family, didn't you? Son still in cryo? I could pull some strings, get him to the front of the line.
Really?
Yeah, really.
They told me he wasn't essential, but I miss him.
I know. I got family too, Ben.
It's done. Addison's gonna kill me.
Smooth.
Nicely done.
Part of the job, Pathfinder. All things considered, it was an easy ask. And right now, you need people tearing down obstacles, not putting up more.
Yeah.
Finally, someone who cares about doing stuff and not just talking about it.
Everything's state of the art. Labs, sensors, exploration gear. Plus her crew, of course. The best in their field.
Ah, glad to see you looking well.
The engine core is based on the Ark's Odyssey drive.
It runs a hell of a lot quieter.
That's Gil Brody. Engineer, mechanic, all-around wrench jockey. We call this the research room. There's space for upgrading equipment, gathering intel.
Router engaged. Securing connection to Tempest.
Welcome aboard, Sam. And Ryder, of course.
All run by Suvi Anwar, our science officer. Your quarters are below. Plenty of space up here to get everyone together. It's all yours. She's light, stealthy, and the fastest ship in her class.
This will be fun.
It's really going to be something, isn't it?
I haven't even shown you the best part. When you're ready to fly, head over to the bridge. Our pilot should have everything good to go.
Better head to the bridge when we're ready to go.
Yeah. Let's check everything out before.
The meeting room. You can make vid calls from the central table or just get the crew together.
All right. Don't think there's any reason to do that right now. Is there? No. All right. Let's try and find a way down.
We call this the research room. You can run research projects and coordinate with the Nexus from here.
Pathfinder, check this toy.
Hey, what's up?
Seems like we're forever racing, but there's always time to check out new toys. Useful ones.
I'm all about what's useful.
Oh, this is. Especially if you grabbed anything from Habitat 7. Raw minerals, tech, doesn't matter. The research station will strip that stuff down, give you options.
Good. Let's adapt to survive, right?
We can craft our way through. Turn the junk we find into an advantage.
Hey, with tech like this, it won't be junk for long. Not after we're through. If the best we get is what we make, still the best. Check it out.
Research. Select research to unlock new blueprints and augments by spending research data. Yeah. Basically, we gain research data by scanning stuff. You may have already wondered about that. We basically gain Milky Way research data, Helios research data, and also unknown research data by just scanning things, and then we can invest them into creating things. First, we have to create sort of blueprints by that, by investing research. So there's three categories. Yeah, I just said that. Yeah, so we can just research stuff. Like, we could try and research some of the weapons that the enemies are using against us. Which might be interesting. Like, maybe I need a new sniper rifle, for instance, you know? Always make use of more badass sniper rifles. So, but in order to produce something, we first have to invest research into it, and then we also have to invest resources into actually building it. And since we barely have any research, resources to speak of, it's really not useful to do it, but technically we can, like, do a lot. Like, if we want to have an Asari sword or a Krogan hammer, We can get that at some point, I guess. Plus, we can get better augmentations and different armors that are better, you know? N7, no. We're not an N7, we shouldn't be like out here wearing N7 armor just because our father did. Feels horribly wrong. Alright. Anyway, I'm not gonna do something here just now, but later, I guess. Once we research stuff, we have to go to development and just build things. We already have a few blueprints, so for instance, we could like research a Carnifex pistol. Alright. No. I wanted to compare it with like the Predator. For instance, I can compare the Carnifex as a sort of different pistol than my Predator. Like, it has a lot more damage per shot, lower rate of fire, like only like by a factor of 4. Damage is more than a factor of 4 higher though. Max clip size is lower and the max ammo is also much lower, not that much, only a factor of like 3rd. And it's heavier. So shotgun, incisor, ugh, if it's anything like incisor was before, probably not. The medic, phalanx. That's double the damage, a little bit more than half the rate of fire. Upsize, less, and ammo a little bit less, but not that much. Also a little bit heavier. Probably just strictly better than a Predator, other than the slower rate of fire. So let's actually build something. Do we want to go with the Carnifex or with the Phalanx? I actually like the Phalanx. Let's go with the Phalanx. So now we successfully developed the Phalanx and we can now equip it. Alright. Goody, we can also do extraction missions from here. Let's check that out again. Destroy enemy warships, for instance. Oh, it still has time remaining. Oh, apparently it did actually send people out. It did send uniform out. Alrighty. Let's also send the Yankees to do that. Not sure we can also lose our strike teams if the mission goes horribly wrong, you know, which knowing the area around here will probably happen at some point, hey. To be honest. Hey. What else do we have here?
That's the bio lab. We can grow plants for food and oxygen, keep any specimen safe.
Good. Food would be nice.
Hey.
Hi.
Our tech lab is an engineer's dream. It's perfect for any delicate technical work.
Just not enough space.
Hey.
Hey. Yeah. I think that's the bridge, right? I want to go to the bridge. We haven't seen the rest of the ship yet. Let's go down. Alright. It's one way of doing that.
These are the Pathfinder's quarters. Your quarters. Sam's router is down there too.
Alright, we have mails already. Interviews from Carrie to Vessa. Hello Pathfinder, I'm a freelance Witmaker. I can use you really as a help with my latest project. It's going to be historic. I hope, just like a mission. Can we meet on the Nexus for a chat? I can explain better in person. Sure. When we're back at the Nexus. Right now we just want to leave, you know? Sam?
Verifying my connection from Hyperion to the Tempest. The Nexus confirms we're free to depart.
Alright. We got some special things. And a rocket. What the hell is this for? Probably for communication, I guess. Guess this for sleeping? It's not a guess. Well, it was an educated guess, at least. Why do we equip our things? Apparently not here. Let's check the surroundings. Hello?
Most of the crew bunks in here. Cozy, huh? But your room's got more of a view.
And way more space. Anyone help me move a couch? Not right now, but I'll keep you on my list, especially if you're biotic and you can drop the weight. Pay back in beer or whatever else we find, Liam comments. Are you serious? I'd have a joke about comfortable seating. I'm gonna do a new info board. Yeah. Successful installation of your info board. You're ready to keep yourself and your staff informed on latest developments on the Tempest. Interesting. Okay, I've set up everyone's user accounts. Have at it. Okay, thanks, Cora. Got our own social network. Tempest Social. Hey, Lexi. You got this. You don't need an old man a few hundred years, your junior, to tell you you're ready for this. I'll do it anyway because I know it's true. You keep your rider safe and I'll do the same with mine. Okay? So that was the deal. Split the riders.
Excuse me. I need to make sure we have everyone's medical files from the Nexus. Come by after launch and we can catch up properly.
Sure, sure, sure. So what do we have here? Cargo bay, looks like.
Ryder.
Cora.
Finalizing orders, flight plan, command access. Ready when you are.
Alright, nobody wants to talk before we leave, okay? I get it. There's a couch here. And a TV, good. Keep some morale.
Securing cargo and checking everything made it on board. The bridge report's ready.
Yeah, just don't push me. I'll go to the bridge eventually. No need to push me. Anyway. I think we haven't been to the engine room, so let's try out this lift here. Lift! No. Hello.
Ryder. Hi there. Can we talk and stuff later? I've got some last minute adjustments.
Yeah, so I get it.
Ready to go when you are.
I get it. No one wants to talk to me.
Hi, Ryder. Hello. I've just got to finish this download from the Nexus. We'll be ready for launch.
Something interesting in downloading? Well, apparently everyone wants us to go to the bridge, so let's do that. I see a lot of structural weaknesses here.
Departure trajectory locked, Nexus Control. Ah, time for introductions. You must be Ryder, Kalojath. A pleasure to be here, and to meet you, of course. I'll be piloting the Tempest at your word. Quite the ship, but it'll take a Pathfinder's guidance to see us through Helios.
Yeah, I'll try to keep us out of trouble.
Plenty of dangers out there, but I'll do my best to avoid them.
That's reassuring. Wouldn't want to lose my finest work to that angry cloud. I was test pilot for the Tempest's early prototypes. I admit, I'm itching to see how she performs out here.
So, how do I...
The console syncs with your implant. Just swipe, touch a destination here, and the nav system calculates everything. Very efficient.
Neat.
It was optimized for a Pathfinder.
Everything's secure, if you're ready.
Is anyone ready for something this big?
Well, we did cross the empty space between galaxies, so...
We signed on for the big stuff when we came to Andromeda.
All right. Excuse me. Excuse me.
Command access is transferring successfully.
Science and monitoring stations look fine. Lexi's reporting in.
Helm is green. Gil reports the drive core is online.
This is it, Ryder. The Tempest is yours, unless you've got something to say for the log.
We were all expecting a golden world. Now there's just a long road ahead. But hold on to that dream. It might see us through.
Nexus Control, this is the Tempest, ident 2527, prepping to depart.
Departure vector verified, Tempest. Godspeed, Pathfinder.
To EOS, then. What would have been our Habitat 1?
Two failed outposts put an end to that idea.
Maybe we can turn things around. Kallo, take us in.
Let's actually go to Pfeiffer first.
About as far as the Nexus surveyors could get before, well...
Let's see what's waiting here. I'm picking up something.
All right.
Probe away. Tracking a huge mineral deposit.
Let's check it out. So, I found some aluminum. It's always good. Back. Whoops. Not that back. How to get back? E. Not that back. System view. Alright. Check out the rest of the system. I think we were also looking for something here. I think there was a team sent here that didn't report back. Maybe we can try to find out something about that. And there's a black hole in the background. Pretty good looking one. Really cold deserts and high temperatures. Limit exploration to twilight hours only. Alrighty. I guess we're not going there. Thick dust clouds, dangerous electrical storms, and heavy gravity. Alright! Inhospitable even for Krogan. Damn it. Gotta say, people will probably be of two different minds when it comes to the exploration part here. I mean, I like these well done and animated sequences here where we're basically traveling between the different objectives here and can go wherever we want. I really like that, and I'm willing to just waste some time on that. No doubt about that. But I probably think that some people will just get annoyed by that. So the planet's highly toxic to most known life forms. Rare's helium-rich atmosphere appears to host enormous colonies of fungal spores. Maybe you don't want to go down there either. Some people will probably just think that's just boring and all. We should be able to tick this box down faster, you know. I want my 100%, but I don't want to sit through it, and you know, try to have fun just seeing new things, you know. So yeah, I like it that it's more immersive than just ticking stuff off of a map. But the outlying world is composed of iron and frozen nitrogen. What already stands out, certain geological features suggest the nitrogen seas were once liquid. Mm-hmm. Let's put that down as nitrogen deposit, maybe. extreme radioactivity and high velocity winds. Yay! Poor candidate for mining spider-rich metal deposits. Well, shame. Let's also go to the black hole, which isn't advisable, so please don't do this at home, kids. So way too close to the black hole, as is, but... How close do you want to get, man? A Kerr black hole. Interesting. Kudos to those of you in the audience who can tell me the difference between a Kerr black hole and a Schwarzschild black hole without looking it up. Your viewership is much appreciated. Even at the distance, the black hole presents a risk to onboard ship systems. The accretion disk ground is composed of remains of at least one solar system destroyed by the black hole's formation and gravitational pull. Caution is advised, yeah. Let's get out of here. Can we actually turn all the way back? No. Shame. Because being that close to the black hole should also distort our view just out of it, but they didn't go for that. Shame. Anyway, let's go out of it, I guess. System view. But you know what? We got our first piece of the exploration candy. Let's actually go back to our ship. In the next episode, we're gonna walk around our ship, and now that our people aren't just, oh, we need to finish up stuff before we leave. You have to have quite the view of the black hole out here. So in the next episode, we're gonna go around the ship and talk to our crew, try and get to know them and all, you know? And then we'll continue to explore stuff, which will be great. So I'll see you next time. Have a good one.